justice. For the last week, we watched a whole county in North Carolina become a potential crime scene. There were hundreds of volunteers stepping in to help. There were helicopters searching from the sky. There were boats and canines and dive teams blanketing the earth, and they were all looking for one thing: any sign of this adorable three-year-old girl who went missing in the middle of the night. And over the weekend, they found the sign. It was in the way of remains of a body they believed to be little Mariah Woods. They found that body in a creek just miles from Mariah's home.
This is a very sad day for the people of Onslow County, certainly for the victim's family. Approximately 5:30 p.m. today, Mariah Woods was recovered by the Fayetteville Police Rescue Dive Team.
But this weekend's horrifying discoveries certainly did not end there, because now we have a pretty good idea of what was happening inside that trailer home where little Mariah lived, with the man who's now been arrested in connection slightly to her death. And I'll explain that in a moment. This is her mother's live-in boyfriend, 32-year-old Earl Kimry. And now Mariah's two brothers, who live in that home as well, may become lead witnesses in the case against him, because they have outlined in CPS documents that he hit them, that he abused them, that he abused drugs, and in a bombshell revelation that he sexually abused little Mariah while their mom stood by and did nothing. Joining me now is Marilee Moore. She's a reporter with CNN affiliate WCTI. She joins me now from Jacksonville, North Carolina. Marilee, the court documents, the CPS documents, are extremely disturbing when it comes to what those two brothers allege happened to their little sister at the hands of the man arrested, Earl Kimry. Can you summarize for me what the documents allege?
Ashley, these are absolutely devastating and worst-case scenario. I mean, so many things coming out of it, but just to bullet point it for you, on one hand, her brothers are saying that, first of all, the mom knew. They're saying that Mr. Kimry actually sexually abused Mariah. He inserted his penis in her mouth, according to these documents. He's also saying that he actually, this is interesting, November 26th, one of the brothers says that he punched them. And that is the day right before Mariah was reported missing. I find that timing very interesting. It also says that Earl Kimry the whole time has been using drugs, which I've been hearing that from the neighbors since day one. They've been telling me this. A lot of stuff to break down in these documents, Ashley.
Okay, so it's important for us to unpack a few things here. Christy Woods is that mother. She has not been charged in any of this yet. We don't know if she will be. Certainly, if these allegations by the brothers are true, there could be some serious trouble ahead for this mother. I want to do a couple of things here, if I can, Marilee. First, I want to play for our audience Christy Woods. When she first came in front of the cameras, I think it was somewhere within 24 hours of the disappearance of Mariah. At that point, we all believed that this little girl might have been taken from her bed, might have wandered off, that she was missing somewhere. We had no indication whatsoever that anyone inside that house, aka one Earl Kimry, her boyfriend, would end up charged in connection with this case. But this is how she appealed to the cameras when we first met this mother, Christy Woods. Have a look.
Please bring her back. I love her. I'll do anything that I can, whatever you want. Just bring her home, please. Save the sound. She's my baby. She's my everything. Everything in the world. Just to be able to touch her and hold her and not let her go again. I'd give anything.
So that was then, and tonight is now. And I want to read for you, if I can. Marilee, you just made a reference to some of the allegations that those brothers have told CPS are now officially in documents that have been served to both mom and dad in this case. But I'm going to give you the language of what CPS officials say they were told from these little boys. And if you've got children in the room, I ask you, 7 o'clock at night, they very well might not be in bed yet. I'm going to give you a pause for a second. Get the kids out of the room. This is nothing that a child should be hearing. Quite frankly, it's not something I want to hear as a mother. But this is official. This girl is likely dead, and that man is likely to be charged in his death. This is what the witnesses in the house say was going on. 3, 2, 1, get the kids out. For starters, CPS officials say the juvenile, and the name is redacted, of one of the brothers, states that he witnessed Mr. Kimry put his penis in the mouth of his sister, Mariah Woods. The juvenile, the name is redacted, states that his mother knew Mr. Kimry was sexually abusing the juvenile, Mariah. The respondent mother failed to protect the juveniles from exposure to sexual abuse. Note, the juveniles. Failed to protect the juveniles from exposure to sexual abuse. The filing continues. The juveniles have disclosed inappropriate discipline by Mr. Kimry, including Mr. Kimry hitting both juveniles with a belt, and Mr. Kimry hitting the juvenile, name redacted, in the face on October 26, 2017, causing the juvenile's nose to bleed. The respondent mother failed to protect the juveniles from discipline from Mr. Kimry. I want you to take note of that date right there in your graphic, November 26th, because that's the date that little Mariah went missing on or about. So the allegation from her brothers, older brothers, aged about 7 and 10, were that one of them was hit in the face so badly his nose bled. Later on, his little sister, dead, vanished, gone. The assumption is it's her. At this point, no official document saying it's her. But when the police told us it was likely her, it seemed very much like it's her. There's one more piece in this CPS filing I want you to be aware of as well. It reads this. The respondent's mother is aware that Mr. Kimry abuses substances, including pot, heroin, and methamphetamines. Now, since you've had a chance to digest all of the things that those brothers have said about Mr. Kimry and their mom, again, their mom, Christy Woods, who you just heard, with the crocodile tears. Now that we know what was going on the night that little girl went missing, it's interesting to watch Christy Woods and her crocodile tears, isn't it? Let's have a look again.
She's like an angel. I had my tubes tied and burnt on each side and fell down. I was pregnant with her. So we call her our little angel. She's got the personality of making you laugh. She's goofy, outgoing, talkative. She knows how to make your day brighter. A lot to this community and people that are here looking for her love her to death.
My last memory with her was feeding her and putting her to bed. And telling her I love her.
I want to feel for her. I really do. I want to feel for any mom who goes on camera and looks like that. I said the same thing about Susan Smith. I felt terrible for Susan Smith when she said some black man carjacked her two little kids and stole them away from her, when in fact, she rolled the car into a lake and drowned them herself. I felt bad for her. I also, at this point, felt bad for Christy Woods, and I don't know if I should. Certified Child Welfare Law Specialist Ashley Wilcutt joins me live from Atlanta. Ashley, it's a professional like you, I need to get me off the ledge, because a lot of stuff happens in a household and moms may not know what their boyfriends are doing or even their dads are doing and vice versa. But when you see that tape of Christy Woods and her tears on the same night, we're hearing those brothers say what was going on in that trailer. And in the same vein that we're hearing that boyfriend allegedly was forcing oral sex on a three-year-old girl, how am I supposed to feel about Christy Woods at this point?
I gotta tell you, look at the size of the home trailer in which they were living. I don't think there's any way that any of us can believe this mother did not know what was going on or should not have known what was going on. I think that law enforcement's done a phenomenal job in this case and has treated this initially as an appropriate Amber Alert missing child, but they've also handled the criminal investigation exceedingly well, and we don't know all the facts yet, but I do not believe that this particular mother was not aware in this particular fact pattern of what was happening to her child and children in the home. That's the worst part.
So we got to be clear at this point. Christy Woods hasn't been charged, but I mean, honestly, how about bring in a defense attorney on this case? CNN and the HLN legal analyst, Joey Jackson, he's also live with us. Ashley, I'll ask you to stand by for a second while I get Joey to weigh in. You have read those documents. You have seen the allegations from the brothers. How is it that Mrs. Woods hasn't been implicated in this case, or is it just a matter of time?
You know, it certainly could be a matter of time, Ashley. So let me say this. I know your first concern is as to this girl, she's gone, dead, horrific. Why no homicide, right? So the reality is that the prosecutors will lodge the charges that they can prove initially, and then when they get more evidence, we'll upgrade. Now, as to the mom, which is a concern also, the mom at this point is not immune. You mentioned and you saw the, you know, what you call crocodile tears. Wow, I looked at it and I was so brought in by this, actually, right? I was so compelled. And then to learn the facts that were really underlying this, I said, you have to be kidding me. And so once the investigation ensues, can and will she be charged? Based upon everything that's written there, I would find it very difficult if she was.
I mean, this is a hot mess of facts in this case. We've
putting it mildly,
yes. I mean, this is a little girl who's dead. There is a boyfriend living in the home who's now facing potentially murder, but not yet.
Right.
Stand by on that. A live-in boyfriend who also, according to two little boys living in that home, was sexually abusing their sister, physically abusing them, while mom stood by knowing and saw these things. I mean, there's just so many, I can't even remember the crimes.
Reckless endangerment, you know, certainly you have the issues of child neglect, which rise to the level, I mean, look at what you were reading there. Kids had to leave the room, right? These are potential felony charges. So the complaint is, or is not, at this point, relating to her. But that doesn't mean that it won't be in the days and months to come.
There is also another set of players in this story. And as you always know, when a child goes missing, parents are number one. It is ground zero for investigators. Whoever lives nearby or is closest to those children are under the most painful scrutiny, not just from the cops, but from the public as well. And so Mariah's father, who hadn't seen her in a year, and Mariah's father's fiance, they joined us on this program last week because they themselves felt the scrutiny and the pressure of whether they had something to do with it. Knowing what we know now, that live-in boyfriend arrested, the molestation accusations from those brothers, let's hear again from Alex Woods, that's Mariah's biological dad, and his fiance Heather Kraft, as they were in the stress of their lives, knowing full well the circumstances they were in. Have a look.
The mom and her boyfriend, like, for some way, it could happen, but I feel 100% that that's not what happened. I mean, for one, I don't feel like she just got up and walked out. Honestly, I think her boyfriend got mad, or Christy got mad, and the little girl woke up, Ryan woke up, and was crying, fussing, whatever. She wanted to go back to bed or something like that, and they got mad.
You have to feel for Joey, this couple. Because I also asked them, have you felt the scrutiny of the public and of your neighbors? And they said they have. And that's not unusual in these cases, until they get vindicated and someone else comes along and ends up taking the rap.
Yeah, and you know what occurs to me, Ashley? Look at where this was occurring, right? Look at the location and the home in which it was occurring. How could it be possible that all these things, we're not talking about little isolated rooms in an apartment building where everyone else had their own room, right? We're talking about one single unit. And so it's very hard to suggest or to say that you were clueless and had no idea that this was going on. And not only as actually witnessing it, but when things happen to people, is there a change in behavior? Is there a change in comportment? Is someone crying? Is someone unhappy? And to do nothing, that's problematic.
I want to be clear as well. And Alex Woods and Heather Kraft haven't answered our messages in the last several days. We've been trying to reach out to them. The CPS document was addressed to him as well. And those children did not go to Alex Woods. So there's some kind of an issue that at least CPS feels he has as well. The children have said something like, I hate my father. He says that's because their mother poisoned them. I mean, it is such a mess of facts, and it's such a distressing story. But you know what? Stay tuned, because we think there's going to be a boatload of charges to be done in this case.
I really agree with that.
Don't go anywhere, please. A high school teacher in Oklahoma is facing charges.